What's up, YouTubers? It's your boy Spectre here, and today I want to talk to you guys about this new game Sucker Punch has announced, Ghost of Yōtei. Well, it's new, but of course we're familiar with the Ghost franchise. Honestly, I'm riding along the same boat with everyone else. I honestly thought I was going to do a sequel to Jin Sakai's story, but you know what? I'm not against this, you know? I feel like that in the end of Ghost of Tsushima, that pretty much wrapped up his story. And this takes 300 years after. So I feel like they're trying to take the Ghost franchise in a direction kind of like how Assassin's Creed went, where we're just like going from like time period to time period. Well, I won't think he's going to be changing from like going to Greek or going to medieval times, or, you know, Assassin's Creed kind of just be all over the place, honestly. But it's funny enough, Assassin's Creed is now doing a samurai theme Assassin's Creed this year too, so we eating good, boys. We eating good. All right, we getting plenty of assassins samurai games coming our way. I'm really looking forward to this game. The Ghost of Yōtei is supposed to take place on like Mount Yōtei. This 300 years later into the 17th century, but the beginning of it. And this is what's all said on the PlayStation blog. So I'm looking forward to this, honestly. Now, I'm not very familiar with the history that this character is supposed to be based on, like what the game's based off of. So honestly, it's all new for me, same way it was with Ghost of Tsushima. And I enjoyed it. I loved the game a lot. I had a lot of fun playing it, especially when they added multiplayer. It was so much fun to play that. Honestly, at some point, I gotta go back and play that again, honestly. Just replay the story, because it was just so much fun. The combat was so much fun. Just so much for you to do. And I can imagine now, they can be able to do so much more. Because when they made Ghost of Tsushima, that was made with the intent for it to be on the PS4. But, you know, I think it came out 2020, so the PS5 came out that year. I think it was 2020 the year it came out. But it's not like everybody got a PS5 all at once because, you know, sellout people's scalpers getting everything and that whole situation was going down. So this time around, everybody has a PS5, right? Well, at least majority of people should have one at this point. But it's crazy to think that the Ghost of Tsushima really came out in 2020. Honestly, it feels like it was a lot longer than that. But when I looked out and I found the announced trailer that came out in 2017. So, like, I kind of got in my head, like, okay, did Ghost of Tsushima come out in 2017? And I'm like, nah, there's no way that game came out that early. Like, but 2020 just feels like so long ago. And maybe due to the whole COVID situation and everything, maybe just, like, kind of pushed it further back into my mind, so it feels like I want to push it back mentally because it's like so much shit went down that year. So, but anyways, with this Ghost of Yōtei, honestly, I'm looking forward to see what I can do with it. And honestly, I think the devs are really excited with this game, and I hope they do a great job. I hope they enjoyed making this game. They have a lot of passion for the games they make, and Sucker Punch can do so much great things. Hopefully, this can lead to a good revolution for PlayStation games going on to the future. This game is set to come out next year, so next year is a big year, obviously. GTA 6, there's probably so many more games that are going to come out next year. I haven't looked at the list for 2025 games yet, so I'm not entirely sure what all the games are going to be, but I'm sure it's going to be a heavy hitter year. And obviously, like I said before, the biggest hitter is going to be GTA 6, but you know, this game coming out, I ain't going to lie, guys, it's definitely going to have to be a contender for Game of the Year, hands down. Like, there's no way the Ghost of Yōtei doesn't go for a contender Game of the Year. I'd be surprised if the game doesn't contend for Game of the Year, honestly. It needs to, because even though the game isn't out yet and we haven't played it yet, I just know this game gonna be a banger. I know it is, bro. We played Ghost of Tsushima, bro. This game definitely was made with passion and love. This game is gonna be a banger. It's gonna probably have so much more new stuff, and she'll probably have a different fight style completely from how Jin fall. So it's like you got that whole thing going on, and then she loves you with dual sword, so I think she'll dual wielding sword. And I also saw her using the I forgot what you call that weapon, but you have the little chain, like scythe chain, and you have like the chain around it. I can't remember what you call that weapon, but that's a really cool weapon though. And honestly, I hope there's so many more weapons we can see that we never thought that we'll see in the Ghost franchise. And who knows where we can go from here, because I mean, if they're gonna go down this route with just the Ghost being from different eras in the 17th century or going all the way up to the 18th century. You know, we don't know how many ghosts we might end up getting in the future, guys. I'm not sure how they want to do this. I don't know if they're going to not never do any sequels to any of the ghosts, like characters, main characters. So, like, after Yōtei, we might just go from her to someone else entirely as the next ghost. I think that's a really cool thing to do. In a way, I also think that a lot of people may also not like that, because some people get attached to these characters and they want to see their characters reach a conclusion. I've seen people already talking about Jin Sakai not getting a conclusion to his story, And in a way, honestly, it's been a while since I played Ghost Shima, so I can't exactly remember how it went, how to end it, honestly. I played it all the way through, and then I came back. I took a break after that, and then, because I played it so much, and then I came back for the multiplayer that came out. And then I played a little bit of the story again, but I can't remember exactly how it ended. I remember for the most part how the story went, but I can't remember how it ended. I think it ended on a pretty satisfying ending. But I've seen some people that there was indeed another war that came like 7 years down the line or something like that. I'm not sure. Like I said, I'm no history accurate person. I'm not really informed on the history. I could look into it and learn and inform myself, of course, which is something I may very well do after this video, because I am very curious to learn more about these characters and just their history, and just to get to know where the duration of this franchise can go. For the most part, though, I know this game is going to be very badass. Very badass. And I cannot wait till it comes out. Man, it's crazy. Honestly, man, now I think about it, I made a video on the Ghost of Tsushima wishlist, like, for the sequel, because I honestly thought they were going to go down a route of just making the sequel of Ghost of Tsushima 2. But this works, too, honestly. I'm not against it. This is a pleasant surprise. And honestly, I welcome it with open arms. So I'm looking forward to see the story of Yōtei. A new scenery, a whole new area, new people, you know, new enemies. Yeah, it's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be like a whole different game entirely. So I definitely am very excited, honestly, and I can't wait. And honestly, I want to hear what you guys think down in the comment section below about this game. How do you feel about the Ghost of Yōtei, and what do you expect to see from this game, and how do you expect it to be different from the Ghost of Tsushima? But with all that being said, folks, thanks for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, like the video, the size of the video, tell me what you think in the comment below. I'm Spectro, and I'll catch you guys next time.